Revelations. The third chapter. And the 10th verse, it says, because thou hast kept the word of my patience, right? And what's the word of his patience? The word of his patience is the words in this book, right? The Holy Bible. Because the nation of Israel, the so-called Negroes, Hispanics, and Native Americans, and all the seed of Israel scattered all over the earth, those that are basically in the faith, right? They've basically held onto the covenant of the Heavenly Father, right? That's why it says, because thou hast kept the word of my patience, I also will keep thee from the hour of temptation, right? And that's why you got me out here making a fool of myself, because, hey, it tells you by the foolishness of preaching, it pleased the Heavenly Father to please them that believe, right? So this is basically a fulfillment of, or an attempt, should I say, of proving my faith, right? And hoping that the Lord accepts this sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto him, right? But I'll read that again. It says, Revelation 3:10, because thou hast kept the word of my patience, I also will keep thee from the hour of temptation, right? Which shall come upon all the world, right? So that hour of temptation is going to come upon all the world, right? Basically, what the hour of temptation is dealing with is the mark of the beast, right? Which is known, when you go into the biblical, when you break it down in the book of Revelations, you come to understand that the RFID chip is basically the mark of the beast, right? That's what the mark of the beast is, the RFID chip, right? So I'm reading on, it says, which shall come upon all the world to try them that dwell upon the earth, right? So that's what's gonna happen. This is the time that we're heading into, right? The hour of temptation. So I'm gonna read this as well to back up the point. It's the book of Jeremiah. Might have to move a bit into the left. Right, this is the book of Jeremiah. Right, so this is Jeremiah 30:7. It says, alas, for that day is great, so that none is like it. It is even a time of Jacob's trouble, but he shall be saved out of it, right? So basically, this is talking about our temptation, the time of Jacob's trouble, right? But basically, it's come to challenge the whole earth. Everyone's going to have to deal with it, right? But then more primarily, it's a testing, approving of the elect to the nation of Israel, okay? So it goes on to say, which is today known as the so-called Negroes, Hispanics, and Native Americans, right? And all the seed of Israel scattered all over the earth. So it says, I'll read it again. It says, alas, for that day is great, right? And when you read the Bible, when it speaks of a day, when you go into the Hebrew word for day, it's yawam, which means it can mean a day, it can mean a set period of time, all right? So that's what it's talking about. It's talking about the day, ultimately, was going to lead into the day of the Lord. It says, alas, for that day is great, so that none is like it. It is even a time of Jacob's trouble, but he shall be saved out of it. Right? Verse 8, it says, for it shall come to pass in that day, saith the Lord of hosts, that will break his yoke from off his neck and burst thy bonds. Right? And the strangers shall no more serve themselves of him. But they shall serve their power, and David their king, whom I will raise up unto them. But the point is that there's going to be an hour of temptation, right? And that's known as the time of Jacob's trouble. Which we're basically, hey, we're in that time right now, man. we're steadily headed to the time of Jacob's trouble. So now going back to the book of Matthew 24. And okay, I'll start from 8. It says, and all these are the beginning of sorrows. Then shall they deliver you up to be afflicted, and shall kill you, and ye shall be hated of all nations for my name's sake. Right? So basically the Heavenly Father is saying that there's gonna come a time and period where they're gonna deliver the prophets of the Most High up to the authorities, basically, to be as in like manner it happened to the Lord, right? The one the world calls Jesus Christ, right? He was delivered up to the authorities. The same thing is gonna happen to his men, alright? Because the servant isn't greater to his master, but the servant should be as his master, alright? So then, and not all, alright, mind you, because he said, the Lord also said there be some standing here that shall not taste death, alright? So that shows you that there's a distinction, but then also fulfillment of prophecy has to come into play, right, for this, and also in the book of Revelation, the 6th chapter, where it says the blood of the prophets, you know, speak unto the Heavenly Father, right, saying how long until you avenge our death. So anyway, it says, I'll read it again, it says, then shall they deliver you up to be afflicted, and shall kill you, right, so the affliction is talking about torture, death, right, it says, and ye shall be hated of all nations for my name's sake, right, and that will be done for the sake of the name of the Lord, the Heavenly Father, okay, the name Yahweh. But then also, that's, you see, they're gonna persecute the men of the Lord, the prophets of Yahweh, Baal Shem, El Shai. But on the flip, they're gonna come, those ones that die in that process, they're gonna come back, all right, first being raised up to meet Yahweh Shai in the heavens when the time of destruction comes, basically, all right. So it says, then shall they, verse 10, sorry, it says, and then shall many be offended and shall betray one another and shall hate one another, all right? And that's the time when we're heading into, division amongst men, all right? It's coming into fruition, okay? And many false prophets shall rise and shall deceive many, all right? And now you got everyone, because of this, you have with the 5G technology, you have thing with the coronavirus, you had everyone basically standing up and saying, ah, this is what's gonna happen, that's what's gonna happen. But ultimately they're false prophets. They fall in that line of being false prophets. Because there's one thing that's gonna happen, right? All things happening right now lead to one place, right? Being the time of the end, right? Dealing with the RFID chip, alright, being the mark of the beast, being World War III, right? And then being the return of the Lord, okay? So if anyone's speaking against that, you're a false prophet, all right? So it says, shall rise and deceive many. And many are being deceived, all right? They're being deceived in the fact that other things are being presented to them, and they're taking heed to those things, because as the Bible, I ain't dealing with any heathen nation, man. I'm talking about you people in the tribes, okay? The so-called Negroes, Hispanics, Native Americans, first of all, that's it. You know, if your spirit resonates with us, I mean, with this word, then more or less you're part of that house as well, okay? But when I'm saying this, it's saying they're being deceived right now, right? You got everyone jumping up to vote for Biden because they don't want Trump in office. But basically, you ain't meant to be voting for no one, right? It tells you in the book of Deuteronomy, the 17th chapter, that basically when you set up a leader over you, it's meant to be someone of your kindred, right? And even it prophesies of who you're going to set up over you, being King David, more or less, all right? And the men of his lineage. Let me actually read that for you very quickly, right? So it's Deuteronomy 17. I'm going to get to, well, I'll start from 14. Actually, I'll get to the point. Deuteronomy 17 and 15, it says, thou shalt in any wise set him king over thee, whom the Lord thy power shall choose, one from among thy brethren, all right? Which ultimately, you know, started off with King Saul being a Benjamite. Well, started with King Saul, but then ultimately ended with King David, right? And he's the throne being set up by him forever, okay? That's why Yahweh Shai, when he comes back, he's coming back to sit in his throne, basically, right? So it says, I'll read it again. It says, thou shalt in any wise set him king over thee. Actually, let me start a verse up. When thou art come unto the land which the Lord thy power giveth thee, and shalt possess it, and shalt dwell therein, and shalt say, I will set a king over me, like as all the nations that are about me, right? Which is a prophecy which was fulfilled during the time of Samuel, okay? Because you had the people come unto Samuel and basically said, like, look, I want to have a king. We want a king over us to rule over us, right? And what Samuel basically said, he took offense, right? Because the Heavenly Father said, but the Heavenly Father said unto him, look, don't be offended, right? They're basically gone against me. And the reason why the Heavenly Father said that is because basically the Most High was the king over the nation of Israel, right? But, you know, it was set up in the spirit because it's prophesied right here, all right? But they wind up, he told them what manner of king they would have over them. And then after, you know, the acts of King Saul, basically, you had King David set up in his stead, right? Whereby his throne was set up forever, right? So, right, so it says, verse 14, when thou art come